a leader meeting. We want you to know that that is the corporate testimony of this band this evening. That through dark days, God has led us. Through times of rejoicing, God has led us. Through times of uncertainty and times of fear and times where we don't know where to go next, God has led us. And it's wonderful for us to share our music tonight as long as you understand that the only reason we share this music is because God has led our lives. Each person on this platform has a testimony of God's faith and God's leading in their life. And the beautiful part of it is that he leads us by his own hand. You see, he is a personal God. He is a God who wants a hand on our life. And all we have to do is let him. And I don't understand what you know about God and understand about God this evening. I don't know where you come from or what knowledge you come with. But we want you to know that our mission and ministry as a band and as believers in Jesus Christ is motivated by the fact that God leads us. And we know he can do that in your life as well. Psalm 118, verse 1, it's going to be on the screen for you. It's a beautiful portion of scripture that says, "Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever." And we've got to be careful with this portion of scripture because it's not a give and take. It's not a, if I'm thankful enough, God's love will endure longer in my life. And if I show God enough thanks, maybe I can bank up some days where he can show more love in my life. It's not a give and take. It is God's love is there and is forever. And he doesn't want to just drip it into our lives. He wants to lavish us. He wants to lay it on us. He wants us to understand his love in our living. I have two sons, and I love talking about my sons because they are great illustrations and because they hate it when I talk about them. And tonight, I just want to focus on my youngest son, Liam. And Liam, there he is. Thank you for dabbing and showing us all where you're at. Liam is a kid who is, well, let's just say, I think he's fonder of mom than he is of dad. I wouldn't say he's a mama's boy, but no, that's actually accurate. He is a mama's boy. He loves spending time with his mom. And one day, Mom and Bright, my oldest son, were off doing something together, and it was going to be Dad and Liam's day of fun. And I was determined that this is the day it all turns around. This is the day it all swings in Dad's favor. And from this point on, he's going to be Dad's boy. And I said, "Liam, we're going to do whatever you want to do today." So it starts off at Chuck E. Cheese on a Saturday. Chuck E. Cheese on Saturday smells of pizza and socks. But my kid wants to go, so I take my kid to Chuck E. Cheese. And then, what do you want to do next? I want to go to Five Below. It's his favorite store in all of Earth. Five Below. To buy things for $5 or less. Now, the thriftiness he gets from Dad. So I don't know why he's so attracted to Mom. And then, after all this, we've had a blast, we've had food, we've been at Chuck E. Cheese, we've been to Five Below. "Liam, what do you want to do next?" And he looks at me with very tender eyes and a very sweet, delicate voice and says, "How about we call Mom?" You see, you can't just win some people over. And that's not the point of God's love. And that's not why his love endures. And that's not why we're thankful. We're not thankful because he loves us so much. We are thankful because his love impacts our life and it compels us to thanksgiving. It is the only appropriate response for his love in our life. He loved us so much that he's given his son to die for us. He's given his son to die in our place so that we can experience his love in a whole new way. It's amazing to me when we think about love, we really can't live out Psalm 118 in our lives without the love of the Redeemer, without the knowledge of the Redeemer, without the relationship with the Redeemer in our own lives. He leads us because he loves us. We are thankful because it is the only appropriate response for the love that he lavishes upon us. As we gather, you know, this week for our Thanksgiving celebration as a nation, let's not be thankful hoping to get more love from God. Let's be thankful because we've got all of God's love we will ever need. That's our message for you this evening. We hope you know that. We hope you can live Psalm 118 in your life. To say that I will give thanks because he's good and because his love endures forever and it's impacted my life in a way that nothing on this earth ever can. Will you have a prayer with me? Father God, we do love you this evening, and we thank you, God, for your incredible gift of love for us. We thank you, God, that we have this expression of thanksgiving to show you just how much your love compels us and how grateful we are for the gift you've given us in Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, that this psalm doesn't have to be just words in our scriptures, but it can be something that we live out in our life each and every day with the help of your Holy Spirit. We thank you, Lord, that that is the focus and the centerpiece of all that we do this evening in worship, to understand your love, to understand your leading, to understand that by your help we can stand for Christ in this world. So we thank you, God. We give you thanks that you deserve because we are compelled to do so in response to your love. We thank you for what we've been able to share together this evening. We pray that your Holy Spirit continues to guide and direct us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Before I turn it over to Bill, on the back of your programs this evening, there's a little blurb at the bottom that says our spring concert is coming in May. We want you to save the date because that is our 125th celebration weekend. This choir in 2018 will have been in Flint for 125 years. We have three soldiers that have been here the whole time. We look forward to celebrating in May. We're going to block out that whole weekend. The Chicago Staff Band is coming. Bill Himes is coming. We have Bill on retainer now, so he just serves at our pleasure and comes whenever we ask him to. Jim Curnow, who was mentioned tonight, is coming. Colonels Jeff and Dorothy Smith are coming. Jeff is a product of this corps and of Flint, and we are happy to welcome them all back that weekend. So there's going to be more news about that. Please follow us on Facebook. And just watch that space and find out what's coming. We have some exciting developments, and we hope to see you there. God bless you.
Well, we come to the final item of this evening. And for those of you who don't know too much about the Salvation Army, you may think that these S's mean Salvation Army, but they don't. They mean saved to serve. And so we take that love that the captain talked about, we claim it, but it has to live out on us, in us, in love to other people. And that's how we serve. There's a very big program that's coming to Genesee County. It's starting in the new year. Is that correct, Captain? And it's called Pathway of Hope, the name of this piece. Now, Pathway of Hope is kind of like, I call it social services on steroids, because it's sort of that concept of, you know, it's better to teach a man how to fish than to give him a fish. It's very interventional, and I've already seen it in my Salvation Army back home, where it's helped people get on a firm footing on their own without having to come back every month. Sometimes it requires housing. Sometimes it requires a vehicle. Sometimes it requires job training, or learning how to budget, or those kinds of home skills. But that's what Pathway of Hope is all about. And the people who dreamt up this idea were the leaders of the Salvation Army in the Midwest for about 13 years. And yes, they retired. And yes, they asked me to write a piece for them. So I wrote this piece called Pathway of Hope. Now, that's a difficult subject to depict in music, but it sort of falls into three areas. First of all, the situation. What is the situation when somebody comes in our door and needs help? And the song that seemed to express it the best, a real heart cry, is that old spiritual, "Sometimes I feel like a motherless child." It's just so hopeless. And the other verse that says, "Sometimes I feel like I'm almost done." been there? People who come in our doors are there. And that's our situation, and that's depicted in a very sort of slow and bluesy setting of that spiritual. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. And then it goes into the solution. Now that's interesting to me, but this song I learned it right here in this place because our choir sang it very often, and it was the first time I'd heard it. And it's called Reach Out and Touch. And there are several qualifiers in there. A soul that is hungry. A spirit in despair. A life torn and dirty. A man who is lonely, if you care. And I love this phrase, reach out and touch, though touching means losing a part of your own self, if you dare. And then it concludes by saying, reach out and touch, and let the smile of God touch through you. That's our solution, because we're saved to serve. It has to output in some way. So then we finish up with sort of a hopelessness to a hopefulness in that middle section. And then we get to a hope-filled area, and that's what I call the strategy. And there I claim an old war song of the Salvation Army that says, storm the forts of darkness, bring them down. And there's a phrase that says, and over you'll hear that rhythm reiterated, it's pull down the devil's kingdom where'er he holds dominion. Pull down the devil's kingdom. It's a fight, and we're in it. And Genesee County is going to be going off into it in a big way, starting this new year with Pathway of Hope. And my prayer for you is that you will effectively, in Jesus' name, storm the forts of darkness. And together we can conquer this systemic poverty that goes from generation to generation. It's a cycle that needs to be broken. Our final number, Pathway of Hope.
Thank you. wanted to say again, thank you for joining us. There's some other things, other events coming up that we want to make sure that you're aware of. If you search hard enough in this group, you will find members of a couple different groups that also have concerts this weekend, so I'll give a little plug for them. Tomorrow evening at the Royal Oak Citadel, the Royal Oak Band and Saucers Thanksgiving concert will be happening. Sunday evening at the Dearborn Heights Citadel, the Dearborn Heights Citadel Band Thanksgiving concert will be happening. Just like this, same message, similar message, we're all one army. We all have a great, rich history in brass banding, and we continue to put these concerts on year after year. And we hope that you folks join us year after year, so thanks again for coming. Be sure to check those out tomorrow if you're in the area, and Sunday. Make the trifecta of it for the weekend and hit them all. It will be good. Following our benediction, we are all invited to partake in refreshments. If you'd like to join us, everyone is invited. You just go out of the sanctuary, take a right. When you hit the wall, turn right. When you hit the wall, turn right. And you will head right into our multi-purpose gymnasium where we have food available. So we hope that you stick around for a while and join us for that. Yes, I do have one more. We also want to again show our appreciation for our special guest for this evening. It's a lot of work to put on in a concert. It's even more work to then come up with what you're going to say and have to think of all of that. So for me, it was a blessing to have Bill here because he did all the talking and I didn't have to worry about any of that. So why don't you join with me again in thanking our special guest this evening, Bill.